Well, it's true that I have been a doctor myself. I've been a primario in obstetrics, so I know everything professionally. And at one point, I became aware that it's not for doctors to meddle in this thing, because childbirth or pregnancy is not a sickness. It is expression, or rather it is life expressing. And it has been said that regarding the great mysteries, nothing can be said with words, only with images, symbol, and music. This is why in all my films there is no commentary, no talking over, only images and sounds. Then the mind becomes quiet. And it's only the moment the mind becomes quiet that you can feel beyond, as it were.
So basically everything happens through metaphor, symbolism,
exactly.
Pictures.
It takes
talk
you from
the unconscious directly.
It takes you from the little ego to a high level of consciousness. You look, you listen, and that's what they do it. And you can really perceive something if your mind becomes completely silent and quiet.
That's exactly what happened to me the first time I saw the movie.
Exactly.
I stood up and I went to bed.
Exactly.
And it was staying with me the whole night and I guess the whole
month. Because that it where it takes you back to a stage of your life when you were not yet talking. And the deepest impression in our life come from the very beginning of life. And at this point you don't talk.
No.
But you communicate in a different way. As it is said, from heart to heart. Truth is that childbirth is a solitary experience. This is what women have told me. And they say that it's solitary, but not lonely. The difference is very subtle, but very important. In lonely, there is a touch of sadness. In solitary, nothing of the kind. Solitary means self-reliant, self-dependent. And during labor moment, woman enters into labor, she's completely alone. And she's discovering, finding out, her true height dimension. She feels, this is really selflessness. I'm not feeling for myself, I'm feeling for this child. I'm giving this child its freedom. And this is the beginning of true freedom. Freedom is just to be free from the mother.
And the mother itself connects and
exactly.
Says,
and this
no.
Is the selflessness. Only a woman can experience and know what is selflessness. Men can never know.
So basically giving birth is a true mystic experience for
absolutely
for
absolutely.
The mother and
exactly.
For the child.
Absolutely.
And no one can really be part of it.
No. She's not small, petty and limited as our ego, the little I. She touches and the dementia, she becomes one with life. This is why it is so frightening also.
It's very frightening, but I remember the picture in your movie where the waves comes from the
yes.
Earth, water, goes all the way up and then it's very strong
very
and then come back as a circle. And there I remember some people when they had a regression in the womb, they remember when the mother was contracting and stopping the wave. It's like going against this
exactly.
Wave.
Exactly. Women suffer in childbirth, or rather in delivery, in labor, because they try to fight the process. It is so powerful, they're afraid, and they try to stop it.
Mm.
But it's much stronger than
they cannot stop the wave.
Impossible. Everybody knew that giving birth can be painful for women. Nobody ever asked the question, how is it for the child? was a question that I started asking myself, and asking myself, but how is it that the poor child is screaming when it's born? He should be so happy to be out of its prison. He can move, he can stretch. He should say, oh, but it's fantastic to be born. Huh? And children are desperate. And the urshai, the primal scream, is a scream of complete distress. So it is where, as it were, it's a cry of complete despair. So I started asking myself, but why? And little by little, I paid attention to the child, and slowly, it took years and years. I had the privilege and the joy of having children born who would start playing, discovering the true nature of life. Life is playing. It's got no purpose. Life is not after achieving anything. Life is just playing. And play is the essence of life. Life is playing. And I could see children who were opening their eyes, looking, as I'm looking at you, with such an intensity. Once you have met the eyes of a newborn baby, really, it hits you in the heart.
It doesn't look like a newborn, it looks very ancient.
Exactly, absolutely. So my whole book was painless, or rather, birth without violence. The title is not absolutely perfect, all right, but it was all about how does it feel to be born. And this memory is with each one of us, but it's so dreadful that it's buried deep at the bottom of the unconscious. It all depends on the relationship between the woman and the child. Huh? This travel, this adventure, this sailing, so the story is something, it's an adventure that the two of them are living or going through together. So the only secret is that the mother and the child must be continuously in touch, communicating. Is it all right like this? Is it all right like that? Not with words, of course.
Communion.
Exactly. And whenever there is any kind of anesthesia, this relationship is broken. Now I'm going to tell you a very beautiful story. Very difficult. It cannot be understood, but it's a fact. During labor, it happens at times that the opening of the cervix stops. Meaning to say, labor is not progressing anymore. What happens is that most of the time, the doctor is going to put a drip, use medicine and so on, and that's not the answer. The answer, and this, I had it from a woman, otherwise I would not be able to invent it. It is for the woman to talk to the child and tell the child, now, come on, pull yourself together, be brave, leave me. And the child understands when there is no language yet. So it is a communication from heart to heart, which bypasses language. And it's really a fact, and it's such an extraordinary fact. It's the woman who has been telling me. And then immediately the opening of cervix is completed. It's for the woman to talk to her child and say, now come on, be brave, pull yourself together. You have to go, you have to leave me. Come on.
And it happens.
And it happens.
So is
and there is no language yet.
Communion with the mother.
Exactly. Communion. It is what they call talking from heart to heart. From a very practical point of view, it all depends on your breathing, on your breath. Mm-hmm. If a woman tries to stop the process, she's holding her breath. Mm. If on the contrary
and
she
the child
keeps,
feel it.
Of course.
Yeah.
If on the contrary she keeps breathing out, breathing out, breathing out, with the sound, then she enters into a totally different experience. Inhale does not belong to you.
No.
You have a right only to pushing the air out. And together with the movement.
Okay.
Together with the movement. And the best way to learn all this is from martial arts. So women have to be told, instead of talking about relaxation, feel relaxed, no, they have to feel like a samurai.
So what's the connection with the martial art and...
Because with the practice of martial arts, two things. One, you come face to face with death. And it's true, again, this is what women have been telling me, and time and again, at a certain point of labor, the woman has got the feeling, now I'm going to die.
The same like the child too? The child also comes different?
No. But the woman has got the feeling, now I'm going to die. And she accepts in order to save the child. And what dies is not her body, it is her sense of separation. The feeling that the little ego, no. Suddenly it vanishes. And the moment it vanishes, she becomes boundless, limitless, exactly like life.
Now,
let's go to the films.
Yes.
We have said enough. In fact, we have said
more than enough. Yeah.